settle in, the lightning strikes, the fireworks start, and here we are.
Guys and gals and non-binary pals, welcome back to yet another episode of Power Overdrive Wrestling Pow! My name is Eric Powers. Sitting next to me on this here bench is none other than TW.
Welcome from Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. We're having a fine time here tonight. We're going to enjoy ourselves with the last show, the go-home show, if you will, before this Sunday's pay-per-view, free-per-view, as we call them, Briefcase Full of Guts.
That's right, and opening the show tonight should be quite the show. The hardcore champion herself, Erica Draven, getting a chance at the briefcase. That's right. We could potentially see a champion of not only the hardcore belt, but of the entire women's division in the future if she gets that briefcase full of guts. Tonight, she will be in the ring against Morgana, the succubus from hell, joined by the Infernal One.
Creek, as of late, as long as she has had the Infernal One in her corner, now, whether or not he proves the difference maker this evening, we will see. But as said, one of these two women will be the fifth women's entrant into the Briefcase Full of Guts match.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from the other side of darkness, the Extreme Hardcore Women's Champion, Eric D. Ray Van, Champion.
All right, champion there. On her way to the ring, wearing that belt proudly in all of its neon glory.
If you missed last week's episode, she also kicked off last week's episode of Power Overdrive Wrestling in a Queen City street fight with Sapphire. No pins, no submissions, knockouts only for that hardcore championship. She defended her championship well and proved that she is perhaps... not perhaps, but beyond a shadow of a doubt, the most hardcore wrestler on the POW roster.
That's right. There's only one other wrestler on the roster who has managed to knock someone out in this ring, and it was Iron Jaw.
That would be a sight. Iron Jaw versus Erica Draven.
Maybe that's a match that we need to see in the future.
Who can knock each other out? Knockouts only, no pins, no submissions. I'd watch that in a heartbeat. Here comes Morgana, along with the Infernal One, a pair of demons who have made their way here to the POW roster. At this point, with all I've seen, nothing here at POW surprises me. Demons, vampires, robots, got all kinds of things floating around. So these two are not shocking at all.
Right, that is quite the roster we have been building here at POW. As you said, you never know what's going to be in this ring. But we do know this, it will not be shocking to TW.
That is correct. Not a thing in the world is going to surprise this old self. Not anymore. Having said that, I imagine you're going to come up with something just as surprise to me. And it's gonna fall.
That we may. You never know. With Briefcase Full of Guts coming up, there might be things that shock even you and I.
We are first match of the morning.
Opening with a nice clean lockup. Draven taking Morgana to the corner, holding her there. Showing that strength. Ooh, and not a clean break from Morgana. A reverse bear hug.
And, she still keeps that.
Slam to the mat. A reversal?
Cut.
Snap nightmare.
Into a headlock. Some well-executed mat wrestling here from these two to start the morning.
Exchanging elbows.
Once again, that tie-up back into the corner. Ref splitting them up a second time. Morgana going for that slap one more again. Raven getting in the ref's face now about it, as she has every right to do. Back into the ring. Morgana rolls out of the way.
Reverse leg sweep.
Plants Stomp Raven.
The arm, the shoulder there. Morgana going for that leg lariat there that she's become so known for, reversed by Draven.
Draven can't keep the momentum going. Morgana has shown quite a bit of verve here early this morning, taking the fight to Draven quickly, knowing that she cannot let the hardcore champion get on her groove.
We've all seen what can happen when Erica Draven gets momentum going. And what we're seeing here is Morgana trying to slow that down as much as possible.
She got slowed down there.
A jumping DDT. And the pin. Single count. Over the ropes and then back into the ring there.
The tall suplex.
Knowing that if she goes outside the ring over there, not the best landscape out there with the Infernal One waiting.
From the champion. She can't capitalize. Oh, that leg lariat misses a second time.
Into a pile driver.
Into the pile driver. Morgana wisely rolling while the Infernal One gets in Draven's face, giving her time to get to her feet. But not enough time.
Draven, a missed stomp there. That leg lariat finally connecting. Going into a combo of kicks into the middle of the ring.
Booting the knee there.
POW special.
That chin and neck stretch we know so well. Got kicked to the back of the shoulders. Step through.
Pop up into a takedown. There we go. We have seen a lock-in of the Raven Deathlock there. Unable to keep it in.
Showing her power, powering out.
Morgana now on top of things.
Looking like he unlaced the turnbuckle there. The referee not paying attention, putting it back together.
Morgana delivering a brutal, hurricanrana there after
into
a bulldog.
A
still only able to get a one count on the champ here.
Have to lock, hook that leg, which she has missed every cover tonight, or this morning so far. I apologize. Back and forth here has been amazing. Snap suplex there from Morgana.
We've got some spam in the chat there. Looks like we're going to have to be banning some robots. Some bad robots.
The back of the neck.
Now, just a reminder here that this is not a championship match. This is not for the hardcore belt. This is for an opportunity to be in the Briefcase Full of Guts match. Coming up this Sunday at our first unique pay-per-view, or free-per-view, Briefcase Full of Guts.
One more time, Morgana can't quite seem to get it going, but she also can't quite seem to give it up.
Suplex into a pin, even with the champ's heels on the ropes there, the ref's still going for the count.
Can't net more than two, side slam. Once again, distracted by the infernal one. Looking to give Morgana the attempt to recover. She's crawling for the ropes, but she's not going to make it in time. But the elbow, the face may net her the time. And the infernal one couldn't. Oh, what is this? Unique bit of rope offense here.
Ooh. Yeah, looks like
using the ropes for leverage on
wrenching the arms
to the edge of the referee's five count, and then a boot in the face, knocking Graven off the apron.
Well, what would have been a five count, but went just as long as she could continue to hang there, as the infernal one gaining the attention of the ref there. I think that was probably longer than a five count.
Jumping DDT one more time to the outside this time. A little more damage to the occipital region of Morgana. Dazing her. Five. Six. That side slam, the referee's count. Continuing. As these two are out of the ring, Draven finally wisely taking it back in. Knowing that a count out or double count out will do neither one of them a benefit. The Infernal One, Erica Draven cannot resist talking to the Infernal One. Maybe it is as they say. Maybe we can't resist our demons.
He is a charismatic being, to be sure. Hard to ignore.
Champ finally seems to have found her momentum.
Bring yourself back in. One more. And it connects. The champ looking a little worn, though, does not go for the pin. Instead, goes to brutalize the face of Morgana. The Infernal One getting the ref's attention as he tries to undo the turnbuckle one more time.
From counting.
Draven unable to get the pin. Goes for a finish there. Countered. Countered again. Morgana thrown all the way to the outside. Draven fed up out here, as it would seem, with these antics. Unable to get a proper pin count. Taking some aggression out. Let's hope that it doesn't end up costing her.
Trying to peacock the crowd. Ends up costing her some time.
Goes Draven for... We've seen that move from Junk before. That was a Minotaur press.
The Minotaur press nets a two. The Infernal One trying to catch the referee's attention a second time to keep the count from happening. Can't quite manage it. And now Draven's in a good position. As Morgana struggles back to her feet. Oh, there we are.
There we go, Draven Death Drop.
Draven Death Drop. This will most
that
likely
be
the end.
Oh! The Infernal One pulling the referee out of the ring. That should have been a win right there. In frustration, Draven going to attack the Infernal One, who jumps away from the corner of the ring. Looks like she might be dealing with a bit of frustration, waiting for the ref to get in, waiting for Morgana to gain a little bit of semblance of consciousness there. A knee raise in the corner.
The arm snap there from Morgana. trying to find the momentum she had earlier in this fight.
Brutal arm drag off the ropes, going for a pin off an arm drag.
She gets a 2.5.
The champ just barely being able to push out of that pin there. Countering as Morgana goes for a finish. Like a brutal strike.
Morgana may have had the champ on the ropes, but no longer.
Brutalizing those legs. Perhaps we're going to see her go for that deathlock one more time.
Step there into a headbutt, but Morgana has those horns. Headbutting that person with horns, maybe not the best move. Back to the outside, Morgana can't take advantage. Perfectly willing, it seems, to go for the count-out victory. I don't know that she's put Draven down for a 10 count. She thinks she has.
Draven is down with a 5 at this point, having trouble getting back up to her feet, having been thrown to the concrete out there.
Morgana
7 count finally finds her way back in.
Know that Morgana actually wanted Draven back in the ring. But there we are.
Still able to kick out.
Morgana getting the ref to count up faster.
Such little life being shown by Erica at this point. Big snapmare into another suplex. Could see a triple snap suplex here. Fisherman into the pin. Unfortunately, foot on the rope there, unable to start a pin count. That might be a saving grace for Erica Draven at this point. Oop, who goes it? There it is.
Into her famous Raven Death Drop scene.
A modified version, bringing her whole body down on top of Morgana there, with the feet back rather than forward.
Morgana,
as though she was
more
going for another one. Fireman's carry throw. That leg lariat coming from those tree trunks of legs. Making sure that she has the leverage here to get the pin.
Only the 2.
Into another big side slam.
American Draven can win. Managed to overcome all of the interference, all of the mind games of the Infernal One and Morgana. It should be quite the morning for her. Referee, slow to count.
Only 2 count, of course.
Put it down to at least a 4.
I would be fighting that as well, Erica. You are well within your rights. Just can't lock in that Raven Death Drop again. Both these women going into bear hugs, fighting out. Once again into the corner. Big Raven splash.
Hit again. But only a 2.
Both of these women fighting with everything they have. An incredible match here tonight. Something I thought was going to end much faster.
There we are.
Intensity in this ring is palpable. Once again, another death drop landed. 2, 3, Morgana unable to fight out of the 3rd one.
No Infernal One there to pull the ref out of the ring a second time. Thank you. Erica Draven had that match won multiple times, unable to get the count she needed due to the antics of the Infernal One, who was finally ejected. We saw multiple pile drivers. We saw a trio of Raven Death Drops. But finally, she's overcome Morgana and won her place into the Briefcase Full of Guts match this coming Sunday.
We could be seeing the beginning of a dual championship here, POW Universe. Erica Draven, always a star to keep an eye on. Coming up next, why don't you go ahead and introduce this one, DW? I heard you over there.
Speaking of Briefcase Full of Guts matches, speaking of stars to keep an eye on, Guy Dupont, the man with the mightiest mustache in all of wrestling, has his chance to qualify for Briefcase Full of Guts. Guy Dupont was a man with a star on the rise until it was unfortunately ended by a chainsaw. Since then, he's been on somewhat of a losing streak. He looks to regain it here tonight in a Briefcase Full of Guts qualifier against Pork Chop, a young man who was introduced to us at Extreme Rules, who survived an encounter, survived an encounter with Dr. Yao's Brian. These two technical wrestling machines will go after it's part of the Briefcase Full of Guts match. A match that seems somewhat inimical, perhaps, to their style. We'll see what the champion of this match can do in that match this coming Sunday.
Right. We have two competitors here. One potentially on the rise. One who has been on his way sort of down the mountain. As it were, we'll see if he can get some momentum going again here and get back on top of things, or if Porkchop is just going to use him as the next rung in his ladder against getting that potential revenge against Brian.
Now, keep in mind, Porkchop is a young man who decided to make a go of it as a wrestler after a few classes at the local YMCA. While Guy Dupont has been wrestling his entire life. But we shall see. Here comes Porkchop now. Quarter
champ. Right, tonight we are seeing the Battle of the Singlets. These men in a fighting mood tonight, it would seem. Porkchop certainly ready to give it his all, it would seem.
That's the one thing I admire about this young man.
A little bit more joyful than Porkchop.
I admire about this young man and his short tenure here in POW. Once Porkchop steps between these ropes, he has 100% business at all times. It is as though, you know, he wants to be a wrestler so bad. He's just not quite there yet. But he's going to give it everything he can with every ounce of his tiny, tiny heart.
And we will see what he is able to give tonight here, or this morning, against D, who throws him off after trying to do a lockup.
DuPont side power advantage here tonight.
Guy Dupont, not one of the largest men that we have on the roster, still standing a good head and shoulders above Porkchop, though.
And here comes the spin.
And heading the other direction.
Back the other.
He has gone and dizzied himself up a bit.
every time he goes for the spin, he always comes out of it a little dizzier than his opponent. I don't know quite why. He carries on. Porkchop is not... Oh, I spoke too soon. I was going to say he's not been able to find any momentum, but a few elbows to the gut there put Porkchop in control for just a moment.
Oh, going for another one. Perhaps we're going to see for the first time someone vomit in this ring.
Well, first time in front of an audience, at least. I certainly recall a couple of people vomiting in this ring after hours, but that is neither here nor there.
And going for the pin after the big spin cycle. Kick to the side. Strike to the head. Big backdrop.
He's carrying on.
Oh! Goes to put Porkchop outside. Porkchop reversing it, throwing Gi to the outside.
Two!
And right back in.
And he wants that victory the old-fashioned way.
He's stepping out of the way of a big crossbody. Another side slam, landing Porkchop on his neck and shoulder there. Going for the pin.
Chop's quest not over yet. He has a chance.
He says, get on back in here, little buddy.
The big stall suplex slams poor Porkchop down in the ring. You can hear the ring rattle, even from up here.
Ooh. Big leg sweep from Porkchop there. Corkscrew takedown from DuPont.
Gee puts Porkchop back on his back. Poor young man just can't seem to find a way to get started. And DuPont taunting Porkchop.
Porkchop sitting there just trying to gain an ounce of oxygen into his lungs while DuPont stays on the attack, hitting him with one of those wheel kicks that have made him so famous. That could be it for Porkchop. Nope. Little guy kicks out at two.
E in a good position, sits and waits. Porkchop rises to his feet. Porkchop catches that boot in the stomach.
Landing a takedown and going into a Boston Crab.
Now.
Be able to fight out.
For a moment there, I thought we'd see Porkchop move into what we have come to know. Well, not you, but we have come to know watching him train. It's his patented ankle lock. As Bruce Lee once said, I do not fear a man who's practiced 1,000 kicks a single time. But I fear a man who's practiced 1 kick 1,000 times. Porkchop may not be the greatest wrestler in the world, but his ankle lock is devastating from what we have seen in each of his training sessions.
He just has to be able to lock it in, which he has been unable to get DuPont in a situation in which he could get a hold of that ankle. DuPont going for the chops now, wrenching the arm. Porkchop trying to go on the offensive. Oh, Gi going after the ankle himself.
Chop, though, showing that he wants to be in that briefcase full of guts match because he's got the guts to do it. Gi DuPont with his front flip there.
Yeah, the antics we've become so accustomed to from DuPont. Someone actually fighting out of the POW special, not something we are used to seeing. Package DDT there.
And a jawbreaker as DuPont goes to pick Pork Chop up.
Pork Chop with a big Olympic slam.
Into a cover. Netting himself two. But he's got Guy DuPont down. Now's the time, young man. Now's the time.
Pork Chop's got something in store for Mr. DuPont. Another Olympic slam. Going for the pin. They might be too close to the ropes there. Yep. DuPont with a knee raise right to the bridge of the nose.
Honestly, I don't know if Pork Chop had the strength to drag Guy DuPont back into the center of the ring after that second Olympic slam. But still, just a two count from the ref.
DuPont getting fired up.
Bravely on.
Patted in kicks to the back of the shoulders. Up again into that neck wrench. Has become so popular among all of the competitors here, pal. Once again, a wheel kick. DuPont favoring his back after that. Those Olympic slams seem to have done some damage.
Wheel kick into the cutter, dragging Pork Chop in the center of the ring. Pork Chop not done yet. Hiding gamely on.
Big butterfly pop-up.
Too close to the ropes of his own, maybe.
Hooks the leg, pulls him back in. That's all she wrote for Pork Chop tonight.
Once again, Pork Chop surprising. Showed some great strength, great skill at times. Those Olympic slams, something that we did not see against Brian. Now, I don't know if he's got the strength to put Brian on his shoulders. It seems as though he's, as he's always had, moments of greatness that cannot be capitalized on. But that is a story for another time. Tonight, your victor was Guy DuPont. He will take the seventh spot in the men's briefcase full of guts match this Sunday evening.
Right.
There's but one more briefcase full of guts qualifier on either side. And when these next two matches are done, we will know the full extent of these ladder matches come Sunday.
Right, and coming up next, we have the sixth and final qualifying match for our women's division briefcase full of guts match. Vela Rose, a woman who has been just pulverizing the women's division here at POW. The only woman who has given Erica Draven a loss so far in either one of their runs. Tonight here against Sinister Fox, who will be coming out to the ring, no doubt, with her tag team partner, Aeon Lee. To this ring with purpose today, making it to that ring, strutting a little bit, showing everyone here what they've come to cheer for as she prepares for yet another victory inside the POW ring, looking to find her way at the top of a ladder this Sunday at Briefcase Full of Guts.
But she does not
and her opponent,
do that unopposed.
Accompanied by Iron,
she does not automatically get to be in that Briefcase Full of Guts match. She has to face
Fox.
Sinister Fox, one half of Toxicity. Last week, Ann Lee lost to Diamond Firestone in her qualifier, but Toxicity looking to reverse last week's outcome and put one of their members in the briefcase full of guts. These two have gone back and forth since they debuted at POW at Backlash in a match against each other. Since then, they have learned each other's moves and movesets and styles inside and out, and have formed the first women's tag team here at POW, Toxicity. Tonight, Sinister Fox takes on Vela Rose with her tag team partner at ringside.
And as we've seen, having somebody at, you know, having your back at ringside can make a difference in a match. We haven't seen it produce a win yet here, but we've certainly helped put a match, at least moments of a match, into a competitor's favor. With the Infernal One running interference, as well as Valkyrie having Johnny Mercury at ringside, helping create diversions here and there. Big single arm press.
Vela Rose, of course, the power advantage here. But if Sinister Fox can get going, she will have the speed and quickness on her side.
Beautiful executed drop kick there. Goes for the chin lock. Into a neck breaker. Trying to soften up Vela Rose here. A little early going for a pin.
Well, if I'm Sinister Fox, and I think I have a moment, I'm going to go for a pin early and often. Take any chance I can to end this match as quickly as I can.
Another dropkick there to the spine.
If Vela Rose can get a full head of steam, this match might well be over. Monkey flip. Looking for a jumping knee, but Vela Rose out of the way.
Big belly to back suplex there. Going after the arm.
Showing off of her power, slowing this match down a little, putting it in her favor.
Smashing the face of Sinister Fox there.
A cover and a one count of her own. Going for the neck crank, but Sinister knows it. That elbow gets her some space.
Looks as though Sinister's been training with Gi, pulling off one of his patented wheel kicks. Jumping to the outside. Goes for a kick. Vela answers with a corkscrew takedown, but Sinister right back to her feet to be given a backbreaker on the outside. Vela attempting to go back inside the ring, stopped by Sinister. Then begins throwing hands and lifts.
And that single arm press one more time.
One more time.
The refs count there all the way to seven before these ladies roll back in the ring.
The DDT.
She's not done yet. However, Sinister there, the right hand to the face, and that's her little separation. She's got Vela thrown into the corner. Corner to corner. Oh, Vela goes up, looking to jump over, but Sinister nails her in the knee with a boot. A two count there.
A little bit of a slow two count, I think. That could have been Sinister's right there. With that excellently executed counter into another backbreaker.
Backbreaker of her own.
Right. Aileen Lee, thank you for joining us. You're just in time to see your wife destroyed by toxicity tonight.
Not but a two count. Bayla Rose not down four of the three yet. Sinister Fox, though, has a full head of steam, and she is not slowing down.
Ducks one lariat, unfortunately runs right into a second one.
It was waiting. There's the boot.
Nope. We've seen this in matches before. There it is, the pedigree.
Pedigree.
Right to the face of Sinister Fox. And the three count.
Toxicity fails to get either member into briefcase full of guts. And now, my friends, the women's briefcase full of guts field is completely set for this Sunday night. The first ever women's briefcase full of guts will have six competitors. We will have Siren, Dr. Yao's daughter's eight, Diamond and Firestone, former Cosmic Division champion Florence Thunder, current hardcore champion Erica Draven, and the victor of this match just now, Bayla Rose. One of these six women will climb to the top of the ladder and unhook the briefcase full of guts, netting her a championship match when she wants, on her time, for the title she wants. That is going to be one hell of a match to watch.
Absolutely. Briefcase Full of Guts is going to be an incredible show. We've got so many matches lined up for you. The pinnacle, though, of which are the two ladder matches. And here we're also finding our eighth and final entrant into the men's Briefcase Full of Guts ladder match here between Ditto O'Leary and That Guy. Now, That Guy last week lost a finisher match against Chainsaw, in which one of those men was going to have to never again perform the Canadian Destroyer. That guy lost and is now having to come to the ring with that move no longer in his arsenal. We'll see if he's developed a new finisher or if he's going to be at a loss tonight and end up taking the pin from Ditto. You're not picking up too much of that extra noise. It seems that they're doing some yard work here outside of the Buffalo Wild Wings. Ditto here. Once again, entering the ring without any of his brothers, making a name for himself on his own as potentially the most brutal of the O'Learys.
The most brutal of the O'Learys will have to contend with a man who seems to care for nothing at all. Brutality, kindness, whatever, it is all met with nothing but boredom.
Right, the man with the most nonchalant entrance in all of POW, now making his way to the ring. I'm still never convinced that this man knows that he is in a wrestling match until he actually gets into that ring. Just happened to have wandered in off the street in his bathrobe.
I suppose it counts as shirt enough for Buffalo Wild Wings service. Thankfully, he does at least wear shoes.
Say that for the man. He knows how to lace up a pair of boots.
Or, when they laced up for him months ago and he's never changed out of them.
That's also possible. I can't say I've ever seen him out of them, so I don't know that he's ever taken them off. Ditto, pushing that guy to the corner, keeping him there, having to have the ref take him apart. Ooh, he says no thank you to that drop kick. Once again.
Shoving that guy back to the ropes again. Ditto showing off his strength there for a moment before getting clotheslined to the ground.
Chop answered with a headbutt, answered with two forearms, and a snake eyes to the ropes. That guy throwing in a combination of strikes. A Ditto coming out of the corner hot. Works through takedown. Stomping the head and chest of that guy. Smashing his skull into the mat.
Venting his frustrations. Brother, you tend to have many of them.
Fisherman suplex, then into the corner. Rope-assisted powerbomb, barely a one count there. Ditto avoiding big boot.
And a big Russian leg sweep.
Arm drag, and Ditto is out of the ring. Elbow takedown.
Another chop. Just boot in the knee.
Battle the knees out there on the outside. No knee is safe.
Oh.
Six.
That was quite a unique maneuver there. I don't think I've ever seen that before. A reverse roll into a headstand. Into a splash. Now that guy going to the top rope.
I've seen him come from the middle before, but never the top.
A DDT from the top rope. A powerful maneuver there. Not going for the pin.
Maybe paying the price. Spike DDT from Ditto. But Ditto seems to get fired up now. Maybe finding its footing.
Powering up. One takedown, two takedown.
Off the ropes.
Into a bulldog.
Bulldog.
Ditto means business this morning. Wants his shot at that briefcase full of guts.
An interesting question. Should Ditto O'Leary pull down the briefcase full of guts?
Ooh, a DDT from that guy. Out of nowhere.
Would he perhaps go after the world title against Cannonball Vegas? Or would Ditto O'Leary cash in on his brother's straps and take an opportunity at the tag team championships? Crossbody. Ditto once more, a flurry of blows.
That could be an interesting development to see two of the O'Leary brothers against the other one and Mercury for the tag championship. We've seen these brothers happy to compete against each other before. It wouldn't surprise me if it happened again. Big butterfly DDT from Ditto. That could be it.
He drags that guy to the center of the ring. And there's the cover.
Kick out.
Kick out of two. That guy not quite done. Ditto O'Leary hasn't punched his ticket yet.
Rarely have we seen someone kick out from Ditto O'Leary's butterfly DDT there.
Yeah, they're showing a little energy.
Pele kick there. That guy getting set up for something. For a stomp.
Oh. Into a roll.
Surprise roll-up.
But only a one. Referee looks a little slow to get there. Could have been a two at least. Not that that would have been a three. But still.
Ditto taking that guy down to the mat, slowing him down a little bit, trying to cut off the oxygen supply there.
A wise move for the smaller O'Leary.
That guy reversing it into a headlock. Standing. Ditto taking him to the ropes. Big right hand. Off the ropes. Do a neck breaker.
And the cover from Ditto.
And again, only that
two.
Big elbow to the top of the head once again from the tiniest O'Leary. Fisherman suplex. Not into a pin. But potentially to the top rope.
Ditto O'Leary.
Looking for a big frog splash. Onto the knees.
Oof.
That guy with a pop-up DDT here, potentially trying to turn things around.
There's the cover.
That's right, Ramos. We do know that around these parts, the littlest and the youngest always have to be brutal. That was it! Dirty pool from that guy.
And that'll be his victory. This dirty pool must be what he replaced that Canadian Destroyer with. Shocking me, shocking the POW universe, shocking Ditto O'Leary, putting him down for a three count.
Oh, I am stunned and a little speechless. At this development, a powerful new finisher shown off here tonight by that guy. A bit of an upset. The one O'Leary brother who almost certainly was going to make it into the Briefcase Full of Guts match put down thanks to this new development. Congratulations to that guy and overcoming his lack of being able to use his patented finisher and coming in with a complete new surprise. Wow!
Well, that means our men's Briefcase Full of Guts match field is set as well. That will be an 8-man match. You will see La Pesadilla, the Nightmare, the man they call Chainsaw, the ringmaster of the Orphans, Rick Dotson, who surprisingly defeated Brian, One half of the Monsters Among Men, Iron Jaw. One half of Shark Party, Party Favor. Those two, of course, have a bit of history and tension between them. They could well lose themselves in a fight, as opposed to paying attention to the briefcase match. Mm-hmm. The Infernal One, who won his briefcase full of guts qualifier last week, though his protege did not earlier this morning. And, of course, this morning's two winners, Guy Dupont and That Guy.
Right. So with two incredible ladder matches being completely populated now, full of powerful competitors, people who are not going to give up easily, these are going to be the... We've seen ladder matches here before. We've never seen them with this amount of people. These could be real bloodbaths, with ladders being thrown around everywhere, limbs everywhere, so many people in these matches. It's going to be incredible. It's going to be quite a sight to behold. And it's just 4 days away on Sunday, 9 p.m. at Briefcase Full of Guts. And of course, the people who are able to snatch those briefcases, the men's division and our cosmic division contenders who end up with those briefcases are going to have a shot whenever they want at whatever title they want. Now, we are going to take a brief break here. Less than 5 minutes, and we'll be right back into the action. We have a tag team match coming up between two tag teams that we've wanted to see in action against each other for a very long time. Monsters Among Men and the Ministry going toe-to-toe tonight when we come back. Preparing to go back live one more time. TW, are you there?
Absolutely.
Excellent. Then let's get on into this next match. That tag team match that I promised you right before that very short break.
Right.
the Monsters Among Men, a powerful team indeed, on their way to the ring, getting ready to face their opponents. Of course,
what they seem to forget is they have two monsters waiting for them who will enter the ring after them as well. Maybe not the same kind of monster, but certainly monsters after a fashion.
Right, and of course, their opponents, of course, having the upper hand, coming to the ring tonight as former champions, as well as just a much more solid team in general. Father Ron, of course, was backstage giving E-meter readings. And it looks like Bubba Trucker is that much closer to going clear.
Good for him. I'm glad.
I, of course, was speaking with Father Ron, like I do, earlier this evening, and he has let me know that he is, in fact, looking to expand his ranks as well. So we could potentially be seeing in the future more members of the ministry. I don't know if that's going to be from outside or if he's planning to enlist current members of the roster. Looks like Father Ron stepping into the ring first. Across from Iron Jaw. York,
quite handily lifts Father Ron off of his feet.
Father Ron, of course, able to throw him right back into his corner, giving him a big elbow.
Father Ron at a size disadvantage. He is a large
right
man.
Right into a Kimura clutch.
Right out of it.
Reversed by the monster.
Iron Jaw taking his time, separating that trapezius muscle.
Mm-hmm. As he is wont to do, led to many wins on behalf of himself, on his own, doing some singles runs, and on his team. But it does not look like it is going to be working against Ron right now.
Corner. Tag here, and here comes the Minotaur jump.
Big kick to the sternum. Father Ron able to reverse.
Bodily hurled to the ground by the mighty Minotaur. Who begins punishing Father Ron. Father Ron crawling in agony.
Hello, Savior 9121. Good to see you. Thank you for joining us today.
Monster's cutting the ring in half, tagged Iron Jaw.
Father Ron, of course, happy to take the punishment, as he would be the first to admit to you that he is a sinner, just as we are all sinners, and he is happy to take any form of punishment dished out to him as he believes he deserves it.
Looks to me that he was crawling to his corner, looking for a way out, trying to escape the beatdown that he is experiencing in the ring.
Savior, we are streaming live to you today from a PC, actually. Neither PlayStation nor Xbox.
Good fun. Taking a moment. Tag me and Bubba Trucker says, you take it for a while. I'm done.
Big crossbody, injuring himself on the way down, though, there. Big stomp to the gut. Looked a little low.
Trucker, not the brightest of lads. So the fact that he hurt himself, maybe not too far out of question.
Excellent splash there. Ooh, hot tag to the Minotaur.
To the Minotaur.
Misses his spear. Trucker popping him up, throwing all of the weight of the Minotaur onto the top rope, going for a pin, a little close to the rope there.
Not hooking the leg, something I've seen a lot from Bubba Trucker, that institutional arrogance that comes with associating with the Minotaur.
That bullheadedness, if you will.
I won't, but thank you very much. Fireman's carry. Up into the Minotaur press. And letting Bubba Trucker fall a full 8 feet to the ground below.
Big running Minotaur splash there. Almost a three count.
Perhaps if the ref had been a little faster and not distracted by Father Duran, this match would be over.
Well, Saber, happy to be bringing a little joy into your life this morning. Tag to the good father.
Here comes the big man.
Taunting the Minotaur for still being on the ground, and then proceeds to smash his head into the mat.
Always happy to take the easy way. In the ring, the ref having trouble getting control.
Well, the Trucker there handily bodied the orc there, Iron Jaw. Decides to switch positions with Bubba. Brings the Minotaur to his feet. Back into the corner. Goes for another one of those big elbows. Reversed by the Minotaur. Jonk handing out a brutal lariat into the corner. Posing and now proceeding to brutalize Trucker.
Tag to Iron Jaw, bringing in a fresher competitor. Into the crab. We've seen it before. Trucker trying to crawl for the ropes. Iron Jaw getting in deeper. But Bubba Trucker flexing out.
Now bringing Iron Jaw over to the good father, potentially. Cutting the ring in half, staying on their side. Preventing Iron Jaw from tagging. Corkscrew takedown.
Say many things about the ministry, but I will admit they are canny competitors in a tag team match.
That they are, and that move there, not a choke slam, but a jaw slam, as it were, as it was right on the bottom half of Iron Jaw's iron jaw, and then proceeded to slam him to the mat by it.
Things getting a little dicey, perhaps, for the Spanish announce table. Stan Iron Jaw slamming Bubba Trucker into the apron there, the second hardest part of a POW ring.
That's right.
As everyone knows, the hardest is, of course, the mustache of Guy Dupont. And if you don't know, well, now you know.
Double reversal. Irish whip into a backbreaker from the orc. Something that any member of the ministry will happily shrug off and give back tenfold.
Could give it tenfold if their shoulders weren't getting separated. And here comes Junk, who's got beef with both of these men.
Junk getting powered up in the corner. There's only one way to face people in the ministry.
Bubba Trucker missing a crossbody there. Junk taking time to flex with the crowd.
That's right.
It's not the wisest moves. Grabbing the bull quite literally by the horns.
Smashing his face against the mat. I think we've seen some blood here. As he's brought back to the middle of the ring, face up. Yes, I can confirm Jonk has been busted open as he was thrown against the ropes there. Ministry could be looking for retribution here.
We see it.
That it is. Up and over. Father Ron, after retribution, going in for the count. Bubba Trucker there to stop Iron Jaw. Only a two count, though.
Minotaur and Orc not put down so easily.
Big side slam from the Minotaur. Unable to get Junk, or Iron Jaw, back into the ring, though. Having to continue to face the good father all on his own. Big Minotaur press. Slam. Into the Minotaur splash.
Keeps Father Ron from running from the ring. Into that big fireman's carry. Minotaur press one more time.
Giving Father Ron the
delighting in punishing this madman.
Mm-hmm. The punishment that he so admits himself that he deserves. Ooh, into an orc
power
cutter.
And that'll be the three as Jonk hurls Bubba Trucker from the ring. Monsters claim their victory.
Right, only in double teaming the good father himself were these men, these monsters, able to take a win against the ministry tonight. A well-fought match on both sides, and an excellently crafted finishing maneuver there from the monsters. Perhaps we will be seeing more from these monsters in the future. They have certainly been a force to be reckoned with here in POW. Once again, we have a champion stepping into the ring today. Once again, an exhibition match from that champion against somebody who has been climbing the rungs themselves. Chainsaw.
Seen Chainsaw take on Cannonball in a title match, and Chainsaw unfortunately lost. Now, he has claimed entry into the Briefcase Full of Guts match. Tonight, he calls out the champion just for a match in the ring, and the champion, of course, ever a fighting man, chooses to accept.
That's right. There is no title on the line tonight. Oh, and Guy Dupont here, making his presence known once more, making sure that Chainsaw is well-worn before stepping into the match tonight. Ref checking to make sure the Chainsaw is able to continue. He says he's ready to fight.
Sure enough, there he is. Float over neckbreaker.
Big float over there. Looks like it's possible that, yep, we have lost our stream. Hold on for just a moment. We will be right back. You'll have to bear with us here for just a moment.
There will be plenty of POW action to come.
Yep. And there is plenty of action. Continue to go on here at this well-crafted, well-put-together, well-landscaped, as it turns out, Buffalo Wild Wings. While we wait for our stream to get back, we can recap once again who's going to be going into our matches this weekend at Briefcase Full of Guts. Do you have that list right there in front of you?
Indeed. This Sunday, we have our third free preview event, Briefcase Full of Guts. The centerpiece match, A Briefcase Full of Guts, is a ladder match. And at the top of this ladder lies a briefcase. And inside the briefcase is a contract for a championship match at the time and place of the holder's choosing. That could be right after the champion has defended. They could take the honorable way out and announce their match beforehand. Or they could wait until the champion is downed by some other opponent before they choose to cash in their contract. Now, they also do not have to choose our world champions. Our Cosmic Division champion and Twitch champions are not the only champions whose belts can be targeted. This could go for Erica Draven's hardcore title or Johnny Mercury and Scraps O'Leary's Twin Moon Connection tag belts as well. That being said, in the men's briefcase full of guts match, you will see the Nightmare, La Pesadilla, the man they call Chainsaw, the Ringmaster of the Orphans, Rick Dotson, who beat Dr. Yao's bouncing baby boy, Brian, in a glorious upset of a match to be here. Iron Jaw, the Orc of the Monsters Among Men, who you watched just a moment ago, soundly defeat the Ministry. Party Favor, one half of Shark Party and the half of Shark Party that has always found success here in a POW ring, rarely losing. The Infernal One, the demon straight from hell whose protege Morgana lost her match earlier today, but he won his last week, so he at least will have a chance at the briefcase full of guts. And of course, our two winners from earlier this morning, Guy Dupont, the fighting Frenchman who claimed victory over Poor Porkchop, young man from a local YMCA who's decided to turn his hand to professional wrestling. And last, but most certainly not least in the men's division, that guy who claimed a surprising win over Ditto O'Leary. On the other side of things, in the women's briefcase full of guts match, you will see Siren, a competitor who has not been in the ring too much here at POW, but she finds herself on a big stage in the briefcase full of guts match. She is joined by one of Dr. Yao's children, 08, the robot daughter who has always grown up wanting to be a wrestler. Diamond Firestone, whose career path here in POW had been on the downturn until she claimed victory last week over Aeon Lee. And of course, the first Cosmic Division champion, Florence Thunder. Florence, wanting to get her title back, finding a way by hook or by crook to put herself in that briefcase full of guts match. She wants revenge on Cherry Blossom. She knows it. She needs that briefcase full of guts, but there will be those three women and two more in her way, one of which, the hardcore champion, Erica Draven, looking to become the first double champion here at POW, or perhaps she's wanting to hold on to the contract for a year to protect her hardcore championship reign. Who knows? And the winner of our last women's briefcase full of guts match, Vela Rose. Vela Rose has been an unstoppable force since joining the POW roster. She's the only woman to have defeated Erica Draven in one-on-one singles competition. She has claimed victory after victory after victory, including one this morning over Sinister Fox, to be the last entrant into the Women's Briefcase Full of Guts match. Now, these two matches are ladder matches, which means the first competitor to climb up the ladder and unhook the briefcase will be considered.
We are hopefully coming back to you now. All right. There we are. Right back where we were. Thank you for recapping that. TW, I had to go handle getting our stream back up. And we are back here at the beginning of this match. Big float over sunset flip from the champ there into a Samoan drop. To the corkscrew takedown. Brutal knee to the back there of the man called Chainsaw. And the first pin attempt. Chainsaw turning fate on their head, back to his side, putting in a chin lock here. Now, we've seen a chin lock win matches here at POW, so never underestimate the more simple submission holds.
However, I do not believe the champion's the man that's going to be fazed by a simple chin lock. I say that, but he's still there. Chainsaw finally giving up on it rather than cannonball fighting out.
Clothesline to the back of the head there. Chainsaw sending the champ off the ropes. Answers with a back elbow. Unfazed, the champ answers with a German suplex.
Unfazed is a good way to describe Cannonball Vegas. He has been unfazed by everything the POW universe has thrown at him. Claiming that his title win was a fluke, that he had no business being in that ladder match with Scraps O'Leary after winning a over-the-top battle royal for the second spot in that match.
Drop down.
That he has defended his title, however, against any who have stepped to him, including Chainsaw. He has continued to hold that title. In fact, at our very second pre-preview, Extreme Rules, he was the only champion to defend his championship successfully.
That's right. Not only a fighting champion, someone who's willing to get in this ring every week if he has to prove that he has what it takes to be the champion. A man who has put it on the line, successfully defended it, and is ready to take on whoever challenges him this Sunday for his title, including anybody who winds up with the briefcase full of guts. Chainsaw looking to take things home early. Here he comes with the last shot.
Float over into the cover. That'll be a victory for Chainsaw. A huge win.
After being brutalized by Guy Dupont there at the opening of the match, hits the big finish. He gets a big win against a champion. We could be seeing these two going up against each other very soon again. Chainsaw proving that though he has been put down by the champion before, he is still championship material. That big drop into the pin. Congratulations, Chainsaw.
Chain Sawyer.
Vegas outside, just taking a little nap right now, recovering from his loss.
Chainsaw taking a moment to celebrate, taking a moment to revel in the thrill of victory, especially important going into Sunday's ladder match.
And potentially also taking a moment to thank those of you out there who have been cheering him on week after week as he's been successfully making a name for himself here at POW and keeping that name prevalent.
And now come to our main event. Our tag team champions, Johnny Mercury and Scraps O'Leary, are two men who do not hold any love for each other. A week before Extreme Rules, Scraps O'Leary won a one-on-one match with Father Ron, and what Scraps won in that moment was the right to choose the ministry's opponents at Extreme Rules for the tag championships. Everybody went into it thinking that Scraps O'Leary would choose his brothers, who would come up just short in their own bid to become the contenders for those tag titles. But instead, he chose to pair himself with Johnny Mercury, the only man who has ever handed Scraps O'Leary a loss here at POW. The only man he considers to be on his level here at POW, despite the fact that the two of them are in the midst of a heated back-and-forth rivalry that has lasted multiple months in the ring. Now, just a few weeks ago at Extreme Rules, they won those tag team championships. And tonight, they face each other here again because they still cannot stand each other outside of this ring.
That's right. These two men, these tag team champions who work amazingly well together in this ring, also love facing off against one another.
From Elysian Field,
we will now be seeing both halves of this tag team, of the tag team champions, battling each other. These two always willing to put a rivalry ahead of anything else. Hopefully it does not affect any potential matches that they may be having coming up this weekend. The card has not been set. As long as these two men don't kill each other tonight, they may be defending at Briefcase Full of Guts.
In fact, the only two matches we have set for Briefcase Full of Guts are the Briefcase matches. The rest of the card will be announced closer to showtime. And one thing I will say, one of the true things I enjoy, Johnny Mercury as a tag team champion, holding that Twin Moon Connection belt as his entrance is much shorter, and I appreciate it.
I mean, he is still going to get as much pomp and circumstance out of his entrance as he can.
Heaven forfend he do anything else.
But at least he started his entrance on the ground today. Gone for three corners. Is he going to go for a fourth? All the way across the ring.
It looks like it.
Yeah. One more corner. Making sure everyone in the arena tonight, in this Buffalo Wild Wings, sees that belt.
Wings in Washington, D.C. The real question is, are you wild enough to handle these wings?
Johnny is not set for the Briefcase Full of Guts match. This is not a Briefcase Full of Guts qualifier. This is just these two men willing to beat the crap out of each other.
And his opponent from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing in at 220 pounds, one half.
There's the other half of our tag team champions, Scraps O'Leary. The middlest brother of the O'Learys, the big man. The quote-unquote loyal brother who chose himself for this opportunity rather than either of his siblings. Chose to team with Joni Mercury rather than either of his siblings. Is that truly a loyal brother, or is that a man who just wanted to win?
One could say that he sees, you know, his most rivaled opponent as someone his equal and wanted to give that man a chance. One could see it as Johnny, or rather Scraps, just going into business for himself, no matter what it cost him. And it's potential that it lost him the loyalty of his brothers. Nevertheless, he is the second half entering today of the Twin Moon Connection Championship. Right across the ring from the other half. Scraps O'Leary, not a man to hang on to loyalties, it would seem, as he breaks every potential loyalty. Oh, and Johnny today going for... Oh.
These two, no love lost between our tag team champions.
Not at all. You'd think they would have earned a little semblance of respect from each other, having won tag team championships together, but no, not the case. A surprise neckbreaker there from Mercury. The
backbreaker there from Scraps.
Yeah, something we usually see coming as a finisher from Mercury. Big belly-to-belly suplex from Scraps. Mercury cutting him off in the corner. Putting him to the ring.
These two just brutalizing each other. I would have said it was good fun between the tag champs, but that show of disrespect at the beginning of the match shows that this is still not all just fun for either man.
Scrap said no. He's not tapping out. Hitting Mercury so hard in the face that he hurt his own knuckles. Mercury going to the top rope. Perched up there, waiting for Scraps to potentially get to his feet. Scraps waiting on the outside. Ooh!
Oh. Scraps O'Leary ducking under Johnny's jump. Almost as though he knew what was coming.
Johnny busting his own gut on the outside of the ring there. These two men. Ooh, big float over DDT on the outside.
These two men have gone back and forth so long that they know each other incredibly well. It served them in good stead as tag team champions. Now, it serves them in good stead as competitors against each other.
Ref at a 7 count on the count out.
Scraps into the steps.
Mercury back on the inside. Waiting for the count out. But telling Scraps to get his ass back in the ring.
And Scraps slides in at 9. This match is not over yet.
That's right. Mercury is not happy with a count out. Mercury wants a clean win. As much of a pompous douchebag as he can be, he apparently wants a clean fight in here.
That's something that Scraps O'Leary has perhaps taught him. Jawbreaker from Scraps. Builds a little separation there. Shoulder tackle.
Ah, oh, we've seemed to be joined by yet another bot that's getting blocked.
Scraps O'Leary into the gut wrench powerbomb. Rolling Johnny to the center of the ring, rolling him over, perhaps going for that cover. off the gut wrench powerbomb. Two count. And the tag champ willing to give up. Scraps waiting perhaps for that spear.
There it is.
Rolls back over. One, two, only two. Scraps stunned in the middle of the ring.
Johnny has been working tirelessly to strengthen his core to fight off the effects of the spear, as it's a move that he's sometimes been able to counter into a DDT, but that he's taken so many times, he knows exactly where the points of impact are. He's gotten to where he's less affected by it. Really, we're probably looking for a Superman punch from Scraps to have to actually win tonight.
Johnny taking his moment. Bask there. Scraps back to his feet.
Big forearms.
Pele kick from Mercury.
Going after the arm. Wrenching it to the mat. Picking Scraps back up. Big pump handle slam.
Through.
And a second one. Looking for a third pump handle suplex.
There it is. Scraps O'Leary roaring.
Letting Mercury know that this is his house. Coming after him with brutal clotheslines. Into a second one. Third one off the rope. Goes for the Superman punch, countered with a drop kick from Mercury.
Drop kick in the face. This could be Johnny's opening.
Roll through into the calf crusher.
Close to the ropes. Kind of miscalculation has put Johnny in the hole before, and it looks like it will do again. He goes for the pin.
Only two on the from the calf crush. Mercury contemplating his options from here.
Uh-oh. We've seen this before.
We know exactly what's coming here. And Scraps gets up. We could be seeing the forearm. There it is. This could be another win in the books for Johnny Mercury.
And it is.
And the 1-2-3.
Scraps trying to prove that he is the better half. Champions.
Say what you will about these champions, whether they love each other, hate each other, whether you love both of them, neither of them, only one half of them, they put on a hell of a match. There are reasons why we continue to book them in the main event. These are the faces of POW, ladies and gents, and aliens. A tremendous showing tonight from the Twin Moon Connection here.
Here's your winner, Hail the King.
With the golden half.
Taking a victory.
Coming out on top tonight. Uproarious boos coming from the crowd here. But you love to see it. What a tremendous showing from both halves tonight. This rivalry, long running, still, I think, far from over. We've got many, many more matches in the tank from both of these men against each other and side by side. And we may just see them side by side one more time This Sunday at Briefcase Full of Guts, defending those belts that they wore to the ring today. Big Show this Sunday, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time. We hope to see each and every one of you there. Thank you so much for coming out this morning, supporting the stream. We do this for you. We're here to have fun, but we love having you in the audience. It's not a show without an audience. That being said, a follow, a like, subscribe on YouTube and Twitch. We appreciate more than anything. Thank you so much. Until this Sunday at Briefcase Full of Guts, this is a fond farewell and a thank you from me, Eric Powers.
And myself, good old TW, the man who's not shocked by a damn thing.
That's right. Not shocked at all. Thank you all for coming out tonight. We'll see you next time.